Question was that on consciousness, that knowing, that is Sat and Chit both. Sat means existence and
Sat
means knowing.
Chit, Ananda, consciousness, existence is Brahman, Ananda is Brahman. Existence, consciousness and bliss. Okay. So first let us understand the word called bliss. Okay, what is your question now?
Question was that when you told me, no, sir, that isness is, that is, isness is there. But that knowingness, that consciousness is only with the subject part.
Right, right.
Not on the object part.
Right.
So my reason is that when isness is there, it is deriving that existence from the amness. That is, both are same. That is, because I am, that is, that isness is coming out of. Similarly, that knowingness, that consciousness, that is also derived from myself now. How we can't say that?
No, no. See, okay. His question is, objects in the world, there's the existence, isness. And I have consciousness. So the existence is derived from me, the consciousness. Okay. So it's, what is, what you have to understand, yes, sir. The reality is Sat, Chit, Ananda. Existence, consciousness and bliss. So first let us understand these three characters very clearly. Existence means what? Something which exists irrespective of time and space. Okay? If it's not, it's not space limited, it's not time limited, it exists independent of time and space, called existence. It doesn't change with the space, it doesn't change with the time. So which means it is a dimensionless. Existence has no dimensions. Okay? It's dimensionless. Is it a dot? Is it infinity? Nothing we can say about existence. It's a consciousness. Now, is existence and consciousness separate? They are same. Existence is consciousness. And existence is consciousness and existence is bliss. So now the bliss word you have to understand. Bliss means infinity. Okay? So the moment you say infinity, it's, we get a feeling of expansion. So that expansion is with respect to finite. Finite and infinity. It's not like that. It is infinite because there's no limitation of time, there's no limitation of space. It is dimensionless. Okay? It's not infinity because it's expanded fully. Understand? It has no dimension. It is no dimension, it is no characteristics. For everything in the world, you have a touch, smell, sound, taste, some characteristic is there. For consciousness, no characteristic is there. No time is there, no space is there. No dimension is there, it's not visible. Okay? So since it's not, doesn't have a limitation of time, it doesn't have a limitation of space, and it's dimensionless, it is blissful. The moment time limitation comes, moment space limitation comes, you'll start feeling misery. Okay? That is called awareness, or awareness and consciousness means one and the same. Pure consciousness and pure awareness means same thing. And pure existence also means same thing. Now this pure existence, okay, never changes. But pure existence has an infinite ability of creativity. The ability of the pure existence, infinite ability, it is there for whatever reason. And that infinite ability is called Shakti. Pure existence is called Shiva. That is called Shakti. Shakti keeps on creating a dream, image. Okay? In that she creates a dream world, the dream bodies, and the existence enters into dream bodies in the form of Chidabhasa. Experience itself. To experience.
It enters, you can say enters or...
See, it, what is said, Upanishad says, Brahman entered into body. So Brahman entered into the body, it cannot enter because it's all pervading. So that entered into the body we call as Chidabhasa, reflected consciousness. Because the entering doesn't make sense.
It imagines
as if it is entered, in reality it's a Chidabhasa, reflected consciousness which appears in the body.
When you say body itself is actually created out of that consciousness only.
Yes.
It creates out of consciousness and it enters into that.
Yes. So the difference between the body and world and consciousness is everything is existence, consciousness, bliss only. Okay? But the world has more dominance of the existence aspect. Objects have more dominance of existence aspect. The subject, experience subject, has more dominance of consciousness aspect. Existence and consciousness.
There is only my clarification I require, because when you say the world is having more dominance on the existence, I feel like that, that existence, it can't have independent existence. Definitely it is
we are speaking of imagined world, right?
Yes, sir.
In the imagination.
Yes.
In the imagination, I create a world.
Correct.
Okay? The world is created by my own imagination, which means my own consciousness.
Correct.
The world has object and subject. In the object, it's my own nature that should be reflected.
In subject.
Subject and object. My own nature is reflected in the object as existence. My own nature is reflected in the subject as subject, existence and consciousness.
That is an illusion.
Huh?
The illusion,
it is, it's a dream.
Like
it's a dream. The dream is called Maya.
Okay.
Appearance.
Not in reality, but in that
dream. Reality, nothing has happened. Okay. So the objects will have existence aspect, and subject has existence and consciousness aspect. Please understand, both are happening in a dream called Maya. None of that is real. Reality is nothing has changed to I. Okay? Understand? So now why this dream is taken? Because in this dream, you are searching for yourself. Who is lost? You are lost. How you are lost? Okay, so let me ask you a question. Do you exist? Are you conscious? Are you blissful? No. See. So, it's everybody's experience that they exist. They are conscious. That means Sat and Chit is very clear to you. There's no teaching which is required for you for about Sat and Chit. Are you happy? No. Are you blissful? No. So then what are you doing in your whole of your life? You are searching for happiness. That means you are searching for yourself. You understand? Huh? So the entire spirituality is existence, consciousness, I am. There's no teaching is required. Sat, Chit, you are not teaching. Ananda is missing. Okay? Then you try to, it's a hide and seek game. So you will try to find out, I want get Ananda, for which I need nice husband. Okay? So made to order husband or made to order wife. So you get it. So after the delivery, then you understand, oh, this is not Ananda, something else is Ananda. Okay? Before you realize what is Ananda, two children are born. Then you start looking for, oh, Ananda means these children have to be taken care, this wife has to be taken care, I need more promotion. So the promotion also comes, then also no Ananda. So this constantly there is a hide and seek game of Ananda. When you say search for yourself, you are searching for Ananda. Nobody searches for themselves. Okay?
Searching for Ananda.
No, no, Dukkha, because you are taking the body, you have become limited now. See, unless you become limited, you cannot search for yourself. If you are unlimited, infinite, you cannot search for yourself. And you have to forget completely I am Brahman. Okay, otherwise you can't search for yourself. Right? So what aspect of Brahman? You cannot forget every aspect of Brahman. No. Right? You have to forget. Some aspect of Brahman is forget. Ananda is forgotten. So now you keep on searching for Ananda in everything. In a car, one car you came, now next car, bigger car, bigger car, bigger car. Then after that you have to wait truck only. Then you say, oh, okay.
Small car
to bigger car to bigger car. SUV came. Now I want a bigger car, then you have to buy a truck also. That doesn't work. So then truck car Ananda stops. Okay, then some other Ananda. So like that you keep on constantly looking for Ananda. Then looking for Ananda, lot of strain is there. Lot of struggle is there. Every piece of Ananda comes with a cost, no? Everything, nothing comes free, no? Everything has a price tag attached, right? And marriage means 50 years of your life you have to spend. Two children is in Indian condition, two children is 40 years of your lifetime. Right? In American condition, 16 years of lifetime. Okay, one car means 7 years of working, EMI. One house means 30 years of working. Like that, everything has a price tag attached. So now you have tried, you have paid your price through the nose for Ananda. Then whatever price you paid, Ananda seems to be not getting. There is no, Ananda doesn't come fully. Okay, now you are fed up. I want more Ananda, but I don't have money. I don't have time. So you are exhausted everything. then you start looking for, then somebody says guru is blissful. Yeah, this guy must be having some secret guru, secret app. Then you go.
So we got the address of Shobha Forest and we came
no,
here.
Normally it doesn't happen. Normally you go to many gurus. Each guru promises another certain price. 5,000 rupees one breathing practice. 10,000 rupees another practice. Okay? By the time you have spent enough money, you realize, oh, Ananda is not coming. Some breathing and oxygen is coming.
Health problems.
Okay, some health problem also. So ultimately you are looking for bliss. Okay. Then somehow you find that for bliss you are paying very heavily also. Actually, for your kind information, the biggest market in the world is selling bliss.
Yeah.
Okay? Bliss is the biggest market. Yes, see, take the today's paper advertisement. A beautiful house, apartment. You'll be blissful if you go to the apartment. only, what they don't say is the underline, you have to pay for next 40 years EMI. They don't say.
Small star.
And through the window, if you are able to see, it's another 50 lakhs more. Okay, on river, another so much of money. Right? So, everything, and the entire world, only thing which is sold is bliss.
Right.
Okay? He married. And they lived happily ever after. That's how the story is end. That's how marketing.
That's where the story starts.
That's where the story starts. Right? So everywhere we are looking for a very happy ending. Okay? The entire world is full of selling, marketing, bliss only. Everybody is marketing Brahman only. You don't have to realize. Brahman is everywhere. Not only that, Brahman only is being marketed also. Bliss, bliss, bliss. Okay, then finally you come to, I'm not able to purchase bliss, right? I have tried everything. Okay, married, having children, promotion, job, everything is over. Nothing is working out. Okay, every bliss comes with a mess. So, once the realization starts, then you realize, oh, I have to purchase bliss. There's something called yoga. Let me purchase some bliss through yoga. So, some posture, you do this leg bending, that leg bending, this man. Okay? So, yeah, it is blissful after the posture is over.
Yeah, ultimately it comes, even for a shorter
period. Okay, then that's called asana. So there are people who are sitting in that one leg posture for 1 year, 2 years, searching for bliss. So you look at that fellow, my God, I can't sit for this leg. Guy is sitting with one leg standing. Okay, then people start gathering. Somehow this fellow is blissful. So that's also the, like, if you see the all this newspaper and all, that guy is only there. Somebody is sitting one leg up. One leg down, okay. And there are so much of marketing happens because people keep saying only leg only up and down, right? Then somebody has started walking naked, so my God, he has left everything. That's why he's blissful. Very clear to them. For a bliss purpose, I have marriage, wife, children, job. So this boy has left everything, including the clothes. He is blissful. So you start following that also. Leaving because of less. Okay. Somebody has put a dress, okay, the color dress is changed now. The name has changed to Ananda, okay. Abhayananda, Brahmananda, so many Ananda. Oh my God, this guy has become blissful because he has put a dress and he has a name also Ananda. So that also becomes very good. So you start going. Then somebody says, no, very good breathing practice is Ananda. Okay, you do the breathing practice also. Somewhere Ananda finally is missing, okay. And by that time you have paid very heavily in terms of your lifetime.
Part of your life is over.
Not Paul, full life is gone. Everything is exhausted. Then you think that some bliss you can get in satsang. So you attend satsang. When you are sitting in satsang, very blissful, all these bhajans, prayers, all these excuses sort of kick. The bliss is there. The moment you go home, again the mess comes out. So that also embrace the bliss. Somewhere the bliss is missing. This bliss search for bliss is search for Brahman. And this means Ananda. And you tell me one single thing in life which is not marketed in the name of happiness and Ananda. You tell me. every single thing. You see the advertisement, they are full of marketing for Brahman. You saw the religious scriptures, religious people, they are also marketing Brahman, Ananda. Okay? Conversion, that's also Ananda. So, see, Brahman has so many people marketing. Ananda only. Market is very big actually. 7 billion people. And everybody is ready to pay through their life for that.
They take other
lives also. Without any effort, without any advertisement on his own.
Huh. So, everybody is selling, right? Huh.
Yeah. But
okay, now you are in a state of dead end.
We take another life, Guruji.
Huh. This is, I am not taking one life. I am speaking of a lifetime, sir. So, Brahman is having a fun. Search for hide and seek, search for peace. This is actually called hide and seek game. Our ancestors knew very well. Kanna muche kade gude uddina mute urli hoitu namma haki nimma haki hari hoitu. So that's actually is a the spirituality translated to kanna muche this thing. Kanna muche. I close my eyes, kanna muche kade gude. The whole forest became my prison. Okay, prison is the samsara. Uddina mute urli hoitu. Uddina, what is body is gone. I died. Okay, I died. Another body came into picture. Uddina mute. Namma haki, nimma haki, I left my body also, prana also. Again another body. Okay? But only when the Ajji means the world, the person who closes eyes is called Ajji, wise man. Only when you come to that person, you are free. Okay? If this guy who is blind, who is searching for you touches you, you will become out. So like that, they created a game out of this enlightenment game also. Okay? So, this is not going anywhere. Okay, so now we come to a conclusion. Okay, this permanent happiness or bliss is just impossible to achieve. Okay. Then somewhere hopes is there inside, deep inside hope is there. Because somewhere your nature is there. Happy, I am Brahman, I want happiness is there. Then you somewhere, the grace, you find a master. Then he says, you have struggled a lot, my dear. You have given up your whole of your life, all of your time, all of your money, all of your breath, all of your body to get happiness. All that you have to do to live as happiness is just relax. Realize that you are Brahman. Nanu. 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 Ideha. Mana buddhi. Nanalla. Sachidanandatma. Shivananane. Shivoham. 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 It is your illusion that you are thinking you are a body, you are a mind, you are an intellect, you are dreaming. Wake up from the dream, you are already blissful. Don't have to pay any money, anything for that. So this is how it comes.
This idea of bliss when you told, no? That bliss, what we know, something we comparatively only will come to know.
Just pause, next question. Yeah.
We come to know about bliss only through the small happiness, as you told it, no?
Yeah.
That through some food, some relationship. Something we get it.
Yeah.
That is a temporary happiness.
Happiness.
So that only I can understand this
infinite
bliss which you said.
Yes.
What you told is that the bliss is that is unlimited. That is
infinite.
If there is a limit, there is no bliss. If there is, we are limitless. There is no boundaries. That is why we have bliss. When we have that small happiness, so still we are limited. But at that moment, how we became?
Okay. So here this question is a secret. At least that few thousand rupees I have paid, how do I get maximum happiness out of that? That's the question. So okay, I'm getting some happiness. Can I get more happiness out of that?
Yes.
That is the question.
Maximize.
Anyway, I'm getting a little bit tired. Let me ask. So actually you have to understand the secret of happiness. I will be happy if I get this. Okay, let's say I am just taking jalebi as example. If I eat happy jalebi, I'll be happy. So then what happens? Mind gets agitated. I want to eat jalebi, I want to eat jalebi, I want to eat jalebi. The mind gets agitated. When the mind is agitated, that's called stress, which is opposite of bliss. Okay? Why stress? Because the mind agitated causes a lot of noise in the brain. A lot of noise in the brain creates a lot of chemicals in the body. So it creates a stress. Okay? It is a suffering. I'm giving you jalebi as example, something else also. So when you get the jalebi, momentarily mind stops because it has achieved the objective. I want is always in the future. So when you get the jalebi, it is in the present. The moment mind comes to the present moment, the moment mind comes to the present moment, mind stops projecting future. So when you keep in the mouth, mind is, the body is busy in the eating jalebi. Mind is not now complaining. Okay? So mind has become silent. When the mind has become silent, there's no identity. Self-identity has not come. There's no identity of jalebi also. There's no other. There's only experiencing is going on. When the experience, there's no memory has come. I am the body, I want jalebi, nothing is there. Everything is forgotten. That moment, mind has become silent. In the silent mind, the mind is one with the Brahman, momentarily. Okay? The finite mind has become infinite because there's no limitation imposed in any way. It is in the present moment totally. So, the moment jalebi is over, again it comes up. Now it says, I was very happy eating jalebi. Happiness is only memory. Okay, memory when the mind was not there, mind became silent. When the mind became silent, it's no mind. The no mind state, it calls us happiness. Now it has already gone. It starts looking for the second jalebi, third jalebi, until you get a diabetes. So it, mind doesn't understand the happiness came not because of jalebi, but because it became silent. And in the silence, the happiness of Atma is reflected, that it doesn't know. Okay? So it's always associating the happiness with the jalebi. It happens with the girl, happiness with the boy, happiness with the job. It happens with the object. And I told you, object is not real at all. Object is your perception. So you are always constantly going for illusionary objects. Only way it is to escape is to go to the reality, which is the self.
Here you told about four states. First is that now normal. Now second desire comes. Okay, so that I should have jalebi. So that's second. Third, when you said that tasting the jalebi. Okay, at that time you told that there is no mind.
Mind is silent.
Your soul state. Fourth is that you remember that yeah I had a jalebi.
Yeah.
Okay. Fourth state. The third state which you say I understand that yeah at that time no mind is there. I was enjoyment. I was bliss at that time.
Right.
But actually, the first state itself, when I don't have desire, the jalebi. After that only desire came, after that stress came. At that time also I was not with any stress or any thoughts at that
time. No. See, and you didn't have a jalebi, but you have feeling that I am not happy. For my happiness I need something. That feeling will be there.
So that
incidentally you associate the jalebi. Tomorrow you'll associate with the Mysore Pak, day after tomorrow you'll associate with the girl, day after tomorrow you'll associate with the marriage. So the feeling of something I'm missing, that will be there. There's a deep-rooted sense of something I'm missing in life. That will be there anyway.
Sir, and the fourth one, when you remember that...
Just shift the category, that's all. Hmm? From jalebi to
joy. I'm missing something, I need something for my happiness. So that feeling will be there.
I think we are born with that feeling. We are literally born with
that. No. You grow up with the feeling.
Yeah.
And the child is when the child
When the mind is calm, it's not there. But
And the child when you are just child is born, it has no that feeling.
Yeah.
The moment it starts interacting with society, the feeling starts developing.
Exactly.
That's how I told, divine child, society child, I told, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so the feeling that I am missing something in life is constantly there, nagging.
Bliss is enveloped that is covered by the limitedness. The fourth one, sir, when after that having, we remember that we had jalebi. At that time only we remember that, yeah, I was happy. Yeah, because not really, you say I am happy, but really when you say I am happy, you are already come out of happiness. Ah, when I was happy, actually, at that time, I was happy. When you are happy, the mind is silent, you are not able to express.
The moment you express, you already come out of happiness, but still you say that, you say that I am happy.
Okay, sir, now my question is that if I have jalebi, and the same jalebi, some other guy may not like it.
Yeah.
Okay, and I may like some other thing also.
Yes, sir.
And there is also a comparative that this is less happiness, this is more happiness.
Right, right.
So how can that happiness be less or more?
No, no, that's only your perception. That's only your perception. That's only your sense perception. Oh, this guy has a bigger car, he is very happy. It's a perception. Yes, your mental comparison.
Yeah, comparison is not comparison, but bliss that is no mind when it is there. When you say that
no,
bliss is there.
Your only imagination. Your only imagination, that's all. You imagine happiness and more happiness, what do you imagine only? You give color to that. In fact, the mind never knows bliss. Bliss is a no mind state. Okay? But it gets a sense of bliss, happiness.
After happiness, when we think that I was happy, I am happy.
Actually, you'll never say I was happy. Actually, you say I am happy. But the moment you say I am happy, you are happy. Was it has gone to past tense.
During that period also, I am happy.
No, no. The moment mind, no, no.
Sitting there,
see, the moment you say I am happy, the mind has started coming up. So already you start losing happiness. You don't recognize it.
Still, I like it. I mean, yeah,
I like it.
For 5 minutes, something I don't like that.
Yes.
Until I forget it.
Like after glow of sunset.
Memory.
We are enjoying more because of the piece of.
See, if you are really.
More you told.
If you are.
How can that bliss be more
intensity?
No. More is. Actually, the more and less is just imagination. What is more and what is less? Okay? Definitely you know.
At functional level, it is more and less.
No. Definitely you know. I want infinite bliss, you know. And what you got is only 2 minutes bliss. So that you say limited, I want more. More is in comparison with respect to time. Okay, not the intensity.
The duration of the happiness.
Happiness. Okay. And you know how much expensive to get 2 minutes happiness. It's quite expensive, no? Happiness is the most expensive thing in the world.
The flight doesn't last too long.
So, Brahma is quite expensive.
So once I eat, okay, I'm happy. 2, 3, 4. Then I started disliking it.
No. But
then
then your body has got adjusted.
Yeah.
Body has got tuned to that. So now even if you don't want it, if you know that it's not good for health, body is saying craving for it. So you become now, the tongue is craving it. So you eat. Then it's going to diabetes. So body starts deteriorating. Even if diabetes comes, body doesn't allow you. I want more.
Then you go for samosa.
No, when I have a jalebi, so you told that there is a no mind state. Then you become bliss or happiness itself. Okay, then next moment I ate another jalebi. Again I go into the no mind state and this one. If I suppose 10 jalebis, if I write, I would feel like that I don't.
No, that is in your
so
case.
Why that bliss is
not
constant?
That is in your case. So I don't want any more. Because your body starts rejecting it. The body, some chemicals are produced in the body. Okay, it's too much for you. Sugar overload. So that's what I don't like. It's not about happiness.
When you are eating second or third, you are already comparing. First time when you are eating, that craving was there. And it's all for the body. More than the mindness, no mind state is not there. When we are eating second jalebi, so naturally.
So, now what happening? Why 10th jalebi you are stopping?
Because mind is
I will directly comparing. Come to the question, sir. What I am telling is that jalebi does not have that happiness, okay, character. Mm-hmm. Because different item also can be there giving me that. That no mind, why with that jalebi only I get that no mind?
No,
if I eat something else, something like karela.
No, I am saying.
I will not get
exactly.
That.
No. See.
Because you wanted jalebi.
See, the body, our body is designed and conditioned by the what you eat. Okay, so for example, you are a vegetarian. Okay. So vegetarian food only body accepts. The moment you smell non-vegetarian food, body starts reacting.
Yes.
So that you call as I don't like.
Yeah.
The moment you eat 5 jalebis, body starts revolting. I'm not able to take anymore. This overload. That's why you say I don't like. So why I like something and why I don't like? Because body is conditioned for that. If you are conditioned for non-vegetarian since from childhood, you will look only for non-vegetarian food. Bodies, our bodies are sense organs. They're tuned for that. Okay, mind is only taking input from sense organs and desire. Mind is a decision maker.
Yes.
Okay.
I have a question.
You have a question.
A little, extended on this topic. I have stopped craving for, it's all example, the names. I have stopped craving for jalebi, eateries, building, everything is, I don't enjoy anything. But I'm still craving for something which is unknown.
That's what I'm saying. That's exactly, my dear. That's exactly craving for Brahman.
Brahman.
Brahman is exactly use the word unknown. Unknown is Brahman.
Eliminated so many things.
You have eliminated. See, you have eliminated so many things, but you have not got the right thing.
Yeah.
Right thing is Brahman. you cannot get a Brahman because Brahman is not a thing. It's not available in the market. Okay? It's available here only. Free of cost. So
with eating also.
So Brahman is not a thing. You cannot find Brahman. You are trying to find Brahman, which is Ananda. Brahman cannot be found. Brahman can be found only as I am Brahman. Until that I am Brahman becomes very, very clear to you, Shivoham becomes very clear to you, without any doubt, mind becomes still, so that feeling that I am lacking something will continue.
Why is it so tough to realize that I am the Brahman?
Okay. My dear, how old are you? why it's tough to realize I am Brahman? How old are you?
It's okay.
How old are you?
No. This life it is 48.
This life is 48.
Yeah.
Okay. What's your name?
This life Asha.
What's your profession?
This life psychologist.
So 40 or 50 years of your life, you have been brought up and thinking that you are a woman.
Okay.
You have to get married. You have to have children. Okay. And you are a psychiatrist.
Yeah.
Either a patient or a doctor. So, this is the conditioning you have gone through in life. Okay? So, with this conditioning, you have come here. Once in a month, you come for 2 hours of exposure to some radiation therapy. It's like a chemotherapy. So, you want to give deep-rooted cancer to disappear one day? Huh? 50 years of
strong treatment, no Guruji.
Yeah, 50 years of lifetime of learning. I am trying to reverse in 2 hours, 1 hour. And every day I keep some injections and tablets I keep sending through Sadhguru postings. I don't know how many of you people take that. So it's a deep-rooted conditioning. Okay. So the unconditioning has to be done. And what are required for unconditioning, I am giving the input. So this you have to apply and start applying in your life. You have to understand this is reality and start getting established in the reality. So have you heard of an elephant training, how they do? When the elephant is trained, the baby elephant is very, very powerful. So they tie with a very thick rope. Okay? And very thick rope which cannot be broken. So then after some 4 or 5 months of training, they remove the rope. Okay? They put an ordinary rope. But the 6 months the baby elephant has tried everything. Now it believes that rope is very strong, it will never try. Even a big elephant, they will tie a small rope, it will not move. So it's conditioned. Within 6 months, it is conditioned. You are conditioned for 50 years. And then you say, I am trying to decondition you. Not 50 years, 50 lifetimes conditioning is over. Then you want a quick result. I am giving the quickest result. This thing, jnana is the highest form of treatment. So that I am giving. So whether you have to take it your body. There's nothing higher than this. This is the ultimate medicine. So you have tried all pills, tablets, drugs, injection.
Which has added on to
all you have tried. Okay. This is like a surgery. You have to understand you are not what you are. You are not you. So this is almost like what I'm saying is a complete erasing your old record. A completely new life. So that's why it is said. We have two lives in life. We have two lives. Two times we take birth. First time we take birth in the mother of the womb. This is called biological birth. When we are born from the mother's womb, we are very fresh. Okay. Second time you take a birth in the womb of Guru. That's called Dvija, second birth. When you are born from the second time from Guru, you will become fresh. Now nothing will overtake. Biological mother, within few months, you will start, Maya starts overtaking. Second birth, Maya stops
overtaking.
So that's called second birth. And that's called Dvija in Sanskrit, second birth. I am going through labor pain, whether you are born, I don't know. Actually, I thought this class is your 9th, 8th month class. And you are on the second class.
Sincerely.
It's more than 9 months, right?
Yeah. Are you level of delivery?
That's very comfortable actually.
No, it's like it's stuck in here. Can't come out, neither can't go back.
Okay, let us go back to the class.
Sir, but even jnana, like it is not, it doesn't reverse this whole false learning.
No, no. See, you don't need to reverse. That's what I'm trying to tell you. You have to understand what is false, you have to understand is false.
Correct.
What is real, you have to understand is real. That's jnana. You don't have to remove false. For example, falsehood is like a shadow. You never be able to remove shadow. You don't need to remove the shadow. Right now you are thinking shadow is a ghost. That ghost you have to understand is a shadow. I don't need to remove it. That is freedom. So nobody has to remove jnana. What jnana is required. Wrong understanding you don't have to remove. Right understanding will remove the effect of that.
No, we have to leave the right understanding.
That's where we are.
Yeah. Stuck. It will reduce
pains and aches we are going through life. It will reduce. But I think continuing with this for some time is only really going to establish us in that...
Correct. It requires, right?
Yes.
See, please understand. Whatever I am teaching you in 9 months, in a formal education, you will take few years to learn. And that too with Sanskrit grammar they will start. And they will go through each text. By 5 to 6 years it will take just to learn what I have taught you in 9 months. Okay? Not even get it. And this is no modern day. In ancient days, the qualification for learning this, you should have taken sannyasa. Okay? Basic qualification. Then you should have developed 6 qualities. Guru will test whether he has developed 6 qualities. Shama, Dama, Titiksha, Uparati, Shraddha, Samadhana, Mubukshatva. These qualities are there. Then he will begin the education. Then he will learn for 5-6 years before he can understand this. So what I have done, all those understanding I have made it very simple form. Video PPT and some simple teaching for you people. Okay. So, and you, as per that understanding, you have 0 qualification to come to this class. But if I start looking for people, qualified people, I have to sit alone. So what I do is I try to make you qualified. Give some grace marks, take it.
But it's also a great challenge, it's like colleges or schools are taking, by giving tests, and then only, very high scoring students, and then claiming that they are having good results. But then taking lesser children and then, qualified children and getting good results, that's actually
I am having good fun. Okay. I am trying to make each concept so simple for you people to understand. See, please understand, whatever you learned in this class, you go and talk to a monk which is 30 years in ashram, you will not have understanding this. I have tried to convert their concepts into something very, very simple understanding. So that person has gone through so much of Sanskrit education and learning, that learning becomes his bottleneck. He starts
seeing everything through that.
Okay. Actually, it happened so well. In the temple in Minnesota, I had 1 hour class, 1 hour, 15 minutes class. Who am I? All the people who came were ordinary people, housewives, common people. Okay. So in that 1 hour, 1.5 hour, many of them got, this is my nature. Okay. But there was a scholar who has studied in Gurukula for almost many years. He came and objected to me, your teaching is not correct. Okay. I started differentiating I and me because people can't understand Jiva and Brahman. So I showed only I and me. No, me you have to tell Jiva only. I have to tell Brahman only. Like that he started arguing with me. He stuck with the concepts. Whereas these people were able to relate to I and me very quickly, ordinary people, they get a grasp of it. So now the scholarly this thing, they'll still get stuck in that.
Yeah.
Okay? So they won't understand. It's very damn simple. I also can speak out to you, Brahman and Jivatma and all those things. I speak I and me. So that you can understand in your language. Whereas if you go to a very formal education, it'll take 5 to 6 years before you can really start appreciating what is this. So I need some quick fixes. I try to do some quick fixes, try to convert into something which I'm not precise. I agree. I'm not precise as per the language. Even I am not a scholar. So I try to the scholarly text in my own way, and that I am teaching you people. Otherwise, you interact with any scholar who has studied Vedanta for 10 years, you'll get frustrated.
Right.
Okay? Very frustrated. They are not able to think out of the boundary of that words, stuck in the words. But I take anything and try to convert it to the language, simple language, which people can understand.
But that institution is also required, no sir? To carry forward.
I have not said it is required or not required. I am saying
it's tough to.
Yeah, for general public to reach it, to get it digested, it is easy to digest through simple words.
Simple words. No, but what I am saying is that type of education also doesn't guarantee the quality output. I'm trying to say. So much of rigor they go through, at the end of the day, they're stuck with the rigor rather than the essence.
But somebody will be there out of them who is able to convey that.
Yeah, I'm not saying institutions are required. Okay, institutions are very important. But I'm saying the limitations of that.
See, Chinmayananda and all that, they were able to convey that essence to the public. Even though they had complete knowledge about
it. No, I am saying it is required. But what I am saying is, people are saying, why I started, she said, I am not still got over. I am saying it's just 2 hours of exposure for 9 months. People are going through rigorous exposure for many, many years. Okay? Some people get lost in that rigor. Some people will really get the essence of that. Okay? So, what I have made is very complex subject, try to make it very simple for you people. Digestible form. Okay? It is like a mother, baby is not able to digest food. So what she does, this rice she grinds it, makes it to a paste and puts into mouth. So like that, a complex subject I have made into simple as a paste for you. Something you can eat. So whether you are able to digest, I don't know. And whatever I teach, if a Sanskrit, a formal scholar comes here, they will not accept it. They will not feel comfortable with this teaching. Okay? So they look for very, quoting my, some Vedanta Vakya, all those things. So I am not doing anything.
Mahavakya.
I mean, Mahavakya I will tell, but what I am saying is, they every second moment you have to tell some quote, some Sanskrit, this thing. I don't quote anything. I am telling my experience. This is my experience. This is my understanding.
Ultimately, this is what they're going to learn through the process, no?
Yes. Hopefully. What I'm saying is, I have found many people getting stuck in what they learned, rather in the words, rather than the essence. Mm-hmm. There are a few people who understand the essence and they'll be able to move forward. Okay? Good. So, this I takes many forms of me. Okay? That's why you have been and you have, when I say you, you as a existence, you as a consciousness, you have taken many, many bodies. Ant, elephant, tree, wood, man, woman, these are like mass. And every time when you take a body, you are trying to search for yourself in the form of ananda, bliss. Okay? It is never ending because the bliss cannot be found in the objects. So, the same I takes the form of it also. It means the trees, plants, the earth, everything, non-moving.
And this search for ananda continues forever, I mean at least for most of the...
That's what is restlessness.
Liberated.
You will be always restless. Yeah. See, one happiness you come, next moment you become restless for anything. That restlessness will keep continuing. Until you find yourself. So, it takes the two forms. Me and it. Okay, it means object. It is almost like saying, in your dream, you took a dream body, and you took the body of Paris also. It's only you. Okay, Paris was object, and me, your body, dream body was experiencer. Experiencer and experience is one. They don't come separately. They are one package. Okay. So, this why me is taken? Me is taken for various roles. Social role, doing, action, experiencing, me is required. Like when you go to a 3D movie, you need a goggle to experience, otherwise you can't experience. That's why the me is taken. As long as me is taken unconsciously, it's called karma.
Karma,
unconsciously. Unconsciously, you are not aware of yourself.
Okay.
You want happiness. So that happiness, you keep on taking new bodies. you are not conscious of your own nature. Okay? So that's where the karma is created. Unconsciously you keep on doing something to get happiness. That's called karma. So once you are aware of become this thing, karma stops because you are not doing anything for happiness. Your nature is happiness. Right? Me is taken various roles, social roles. You become a wife, woman, to experience taking care of child, you become a man, you become an elephant. All those various roles are experienced through me. Me is a vehicle, body, mind. And me is also made up of consciousness only. Me is not made up of anything else. It also is made up of consciousness, but the consciousness expression is less there. Because consciousness to express, the mind, something called subtle aspect called mind is required. For them, mind is very rudimentary. Okay? Are you clear? But all the while, this I has nothing has changed. Right? So that is your experience, my dear. What is your experience? 10 years back, I was in Hyderabad. Now I am here. Are who was in Hyderabad? Body has changed, mind has changed, intellect has changed. What has happened to I?
I was there.
That is called Brahman. And you know your Brahman. You know that you are unchanging I. Always you refer to the unchanging I and confuse with the body and mind. What is your profession? I am psychiatrist. Okay, nothing has happened. It doesn't do any job. It's jobless. Okay, then you say I am psychiatrist. You superimpose on the body, mind, role on the self. The entire spirituality is to remove the confusion between the I and me. That's all. It doesn't have to tell you I. You know the I. Has the I changed? Has the I time limitation?
No.
Has the I body space limitation? I is in Hyderabad, I is America, I is in Africa, I is everywhere. So I am that I. And you know that you are I. That's why you always say I. But then always you confuse the body and mind. Why?
Condition.
Ignorance.
So in this class I can only tell you, my dear sir, I and me are different. Don't confuse I and me. Me is a dream character. I is reality. Okay? Me is a shadow. I is real. Don't confuse real and shadow. This only I can understand. Then application is what you do in life. Right? Are you clear between I and me?
Yes.
The me is changing every minute. Every second it is changing. I has never changed, either based on time or place. That's why I is called Satya, me is called Satya. Unreal. Why me is unreal?
Changing.
The body which is there 10 minutes back is not there. Already so much of accumulated in the body. Already so much of something is being generated in the body. Something is dying in the body. Something new is coming up in the body. Mind is constantly changing. Intellect is constantly changing. Nothing is stationary in I. So how can you confuse changing me with unchanging I? Please tell me. How are you confusing that?
No, there is no confusion. I have just forgotten that I. That's all.
Who has forgotten? I can forget itself?
No, I. The me has forgotten the I.
Me has nothing, it's a mithya, it's a shadow, it cannot forget also. So that's why again you are taking the question of me. Have you forgotten I anytime?
No. Who is that you are talking about?
Whoever is speaking. Ashwini is headache? Not able to understand. Not able to understand.
No, I'm getting confused.
Confused, who is getting confused and what is getting? See, I and me, do you understand what is I?
Yeah.
There is some unchanging reality.
Correct.
Which is not visible.
Correct.
Which is always there.
Correct.
Me is a changing reality, body and mind, which is there. Is it your experience that me changes every day?
Yeah.
Every minute?
Yes.
Now, whenever you refer to I, you always refer to me. I was there in Hyderabad. Who was there in Hyderabad?
The me.
Oh, my dear, me. Today's Hyderabad is 10 years back. It is 2008 model. Now this me is 2018 model. 2019 model. Okay. Is 2019 model and me and 2008 model is me same?
No.
Then who was in Hyderabad?
I.
The I was there, unchanging, always there. Yeah.
Me was anytime in Hyderabad?
No.
No. That I was in Hyderabad means what?
No, the
I is everywhere. Okay.
Yeah.
So nobody was anywhere.
Projection of
a dream character saying I was in Hyderabad.
Yeah, that's true, Guruji. But when you say that me is was the I mean me in Hyderabad, I was there, no, everywhere.
I was there everywhere. What is there everywhere is nowhere also, no. What is there everywhere is nowhere also, no. It is not in the time and space.
Yeah, correct.
Even
right.
Now I is in Hyderabad.
Ah, now I is also Hyderabad. So, when you say Hyderabad. I was in Hyderabad, who was in Hyderabad, you tell me.
That me. Changing version was there. Is it you? No.
That as long as you are clear about that, I don't
know.
So now you say, I was never in Hyderabad, is it correct?
No, that is also wrong.
So then was there anybody in Hyderabad?
Nobody.
Okay, now we are talking the same language. So there was an illusion that body-mind complex is me. Okay, now let's come back to Ashwini. Ashwini is having a very, she is spending a lot of bandwidth. So what is confusing, Ashwini?
You got it. Very good.
Who got it? Who got it?
Yeah, safe playing and
you know.
Who got it?
Whom did you ask, Guruji?
The one who says I got it has disappeared. Now, that is actually 1 minute back. Now the new I has come. But is there somebody who has understood it?
New me has come.
So the understanding doesn't belong to the me. Understanding belongs to Chidabhasa, consciousness. The memory, you understand? The consciousness only can understand. Knowing this ability of the consciousness.
So me is Chidabhasa.
Me is body mind complex.
Okay. That is
the consciousness which is coming to me is Chidabhasa. Right? So when you say I understood, she thinks that a girl called Ashwini understood. A girl called Ashwini is a body, it cannot understand. A mind called Ashwini cannot understand. An intellect called Ashwini cannot understand. Because knowing and understanding is ability of consciousness. And what is consciousness? Chidabhasa. So Chidabhasa is not seen. Chidabhasa doesn't change. Now who has the question of memory? Who keeps the memory? Chidabhasa.
Sir, I is a consciousness, awareness.
Yeah.
Okay, awareness. Like me, if there is a body, there is a like mind and intellect. Mm. So this I is, that is body, mind, intellect itself having that I.
A body, mind, intellect has is powered by I.
Powering is. So when we see always me, that is body, mind, complex. So always I is also there in that. Always.
Without I, it's not there. Without I, it cannot exist. And I, the power of I is called Chidabhasa, is there in this. Reflect your consciousness in the body.
Yes, that is me.
That is me. It is mixed with me.
Yes. Mixed with that, the me is coming.
When you say me, the body, mind, and intellect, and Chidabhasa, which is consciousness, together I am calling is me.
Yes.
So understanding, body is changing, mind is changing, intellect is changing.
Yes.
The understanding is for the Chidabhasa with this instrument. You cannot separate them out.
Understanding is for the Chidabhasa. Chidabhasa is not also always there. It is also changing. No, body mind changing.
Chidabhasa doesn't change. As long as the mind is present, Chidabhasa is present. mind is mind. Chidabhasa is reflection in the mind.
Reflection. So if you say the example of like mirror reflecting the light, if mirror is having some colors, so it is reflecting the colored light. So that chidabhasa, if that light is changing, that color is changing. The chidabhasa is also changing. The reflected light is also changing.
Chidabhasa seems to be changing.
Yes.
But chidabhasa is consciousness. It doesn't change.
The light itself not doesn't change.
Change.
But the color but of the light changes.
It appears to be changing because of the change in the mirror. Okay. So that's what is experience in life. So then who remembers the experience? The experience in body, mind, intellect has changed already. Next move, body, mind, intellect come. For whom is the memory?
Memory is not there. That is why.
Memory is a fabric of the mind.
Yes, come to commission, memory is not there, okay.
Because every moment is a fresh moment. So how that memory can happen?
We'll find out. So he has become free now. He has become, no memory, no problem.
In the movie, like no movie, the screen comes, the movie is changing. There is no memory in there.
Fresh.
I go to Chennai, that will be fresh.
Fresh Chennai. So what happens is that the understanding happens for the chidabhasa with the help of the instrument called body, mind, intellect. So earlier it was associating with the body, mind, instrument. Now it is understood. But body, mind, intellect changes. The understanding of chidabhasa, okay, the consciousness. So now it remembers a past event. It's a new perception. Something was there. Okay, for example, did you come for the last class? Okay. For whom I am asking the question? For the consciousness, body, mind, intellect. Consciousness. I can ask a question only body, mind, intellect. Consciousness. No? So now who has to remember that I came to the class?
Same thing.
Body, mind, intellect has changed.
Consciousness.
So consciousness is not changed. Now the consciousness, chidabhasa, it perception momentarily it goes. To where?
Class.
Supposed to be past. Okay. Now it constructs a past in the present moment.
Yes.
So there was a past class. It says now. A past is created in this moment and told, I only came to the class.
That is memory, right?
No. Memory is the thought. That
memory is
the
past.
Is it showing without happening?
Did you come to the last class?
Nothing ever happened.
But you are saying it's creative. So it can create without
Did you come to the last class, yes or no?
Your memory says yes.
So the body mind version called version August class that disappeared or changed. Body mind version called September has come to the class. Who came to the class? What is changing, unchanging in this? Consciousness, chidabhasa, the mind, chidabhasa, mind means the thoughts have changed.
Yeah, thoughts have changed.
Consciousness reflected in the mind is there. That's why you are saying continuity is there.
Yes.
Now, who has to recollect the memory?
Chidabhasa.
Consciousness. So now, that body mind complex is different. That instrument is different. This instrument is different. So, if you recollect, it's a false recollection.
No. September can't recollect August. September version cannot
recollect. Because it's an instrument.
So the only constant in August and September is the
chidabhasa. Okay. And the consciousness always experiences life as present moment only. It doesn't experience as past. Always all your experiences are present. So when you recollect past, what are you recollecting? Is it real or unreal?
No, unreal. And who? Here again, my question that I asked: memory, huh?
Yeah.
Who does the choice? I mean, who?
Chidabhasa. But chidabhasa is very closely identified with the body mind complex. It cannot separate out. So it says, okay, I came to the class. That me has changed, but I has not changed. Still, it says I came to the class. Even the me has changed.
Has never come to the class. Number.
No, yeah, Chidabhasa, which is closely identified with the body mind complex, it is not separated itself. If it separates out, it becomes Brahman.
It's like an interface, right, between I and, can
we
say that?
It is a manifestation. It's like a, it's almost saying, in a dream, you are a dream girl, right? Dream girl, you slept and you became Cinderella. Cinderella doesn't remember your name. she thinks it's so close to the embodiment complex. So when he says I came, okay, that embodiment complex came, but it's chained. Today's embodiment is different, but I is that Chidabhasa has not chained. That's why you are claiming that I only came. Experience is for the Chidabhasa. Okay? Memory is for the Chidabhasa. But when
Chidabhasa changed, no, sir.
Chidabhasa doesn't change.
Chidabhasa doesn't change.
Only I doesn't change.